blank in the ProCal 50 here to show you how easy it is to make a tabletop should you happen to require to make one. The tabletop that comes with the machine does have the kerf line cut for the cross cutting and the groove cut for the rip cut. However, we're putting in a blank just to show you how easy it is to make. So first we're going to cut the kerf cut, and this is for cross cutting. Built into the machine, right here, is a saw depth guide. Very easy to use. With the guard down on the saw, you drop it, the saw down, until the guard just chafes the saw depth guide. You're now set exactly a quarter inch below the material that you're cutting. So what we're going to be doing is cutting a quarter inch kerf into the tabletop. And we're going to do that now. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to now cut the groove for rip cut. And what we want to do is have 2 inches on either side of the machine so that we leave an actual space on both sides of the tabletop, which we're going to make it about 2 inches. Now we're going to turn the saw so it's in rip cut position. Very simple, very quick. Basically loosen all four of the insert locks, turn the saw 90 degrees, and place it back in. You lost the locks. Now, I do want to caution you on this procedure because basically we'll be dropping the blade slightly and we'll be running it back and forth this way. Cut no more than 1/16 of an inch at a time, and I'll show you how to do it. But remember, we just marked back 2 inches. So this is very easy to do. Bring the saw up to the 2 inch mark. And the saw comes obviously with your rotor stops. But we're going to use it in this case to stop the saw. So now, as you can see, the saw is going to come back and stop 2 inches here. I'm going to go to the other side. Saw, set it at 2 inches, and position the rotor stop here. So now the saw is going to stop back here, 2 inches short, and all the way up here, 2 inches short, being stopped by the guide. Very carefully drop the saw no more than 1/16 of an inch.